furnace Sunday morning. Coffee. You know, I don't pretend to be a perfect man. I mean, who could? Perfection's not within the realm of humanity. You know, they say in all of human history, only one man could make this claim. That's Jesus. You know, the guy who gave us, blessed are the peacemakers, for they should be called the children of God. Well, this is the foundation of my church. You know, we live in a time of great evil, with the war and corruption and all the political candidates pointing fingers and judging their fellow man or woman. You know, all the controversy over Obama's pastor, Reverend Wright, from the conservative stiffs suffering from ideological and moral superiority complexes and religious delusions. You know, they believe that Jesus is their very own special friend and personal savior. You know, they follow the madness of guys like Pat Robertson or God's warmonger, Pastor Hagee, and completely forgot the words of the Lord. That's why people are flocking to the Holy Church of the Concerned Citizen. And for all you people out there that think Pastor Wright's remarks were controversial, well, you ain't seen nothing yet. Watch this police surveillance of our church. It'll give you a good idea of what's going on, who the real children of God are.
Here's the video where the police got me. This is the police cut of the video. The day we shut down the 91 freeway, and here is where they identified me right there. Silver hair and all. There's Rob. There's the guy from the city right there. And over here is a Vermont McKinney over here from the U.S. Department of Justice, mediator. We shut down the freeway that day. And it was really fun.
Got a movie for you.
This is the police video here, and that's where they identified me, right there. Cost me 75 days in jail, man.
That was on our side. Come on, where would we be? I know myself, I'd probably be in a dungeon somewhere, but because God's grace is sufficient, I'm not in that dungeon. They cannot silence the truth. No matter how they try, the truth crushed down, beat down, worn down, drugged down, in the Bible that they tried to smother the truth, they tried to kill the dreamer, they tried to take the prophet and do him harm, but God says that his prophets are protected. Right. He said, you remember, Joseph's brother said, here comes the dreamer, let's kill him and see what becomes of his dream. And even if they had killed Joseph, the dream would have went on to someone else, but they could not kill the dreamer, they could not even kill the dream. And this is what's happening here in Riverside and all across our nation. Whether they know it or not, I heard the comments from the city hall that we need to get back to normal. We need to get back to business as usual. And these people are rocking the boat. I'm here to tell you that Abraham was a boat rocker. Moses was a boat rocker. Joseph was a boat rocker.
Corinthians 8:18. The suffering you now endure is nothing compared to the glory that will be revealed in you. We did a lot of suffering over there in the California police state. I can't tell you the evil, the foundations of evil that we rock.
This is where real men make revolution. Sitting on the back of a pickup truck, having a beer after work, talking about revolution, you know? Wah! Oh yeah. You know, ever since I heard George W. Bush call the war a romantic adventure, or I heard about Cheney going to Saudi Arabia, warning them about nuclear fallout radiation from Iran, and probably the thing that made me the most mad today is Rush Limbaugh. I heard about his Operation Chaos, where he's urging Republican voters to go and register as Democrats or vote for the Democrat to screw up our nomination process. You tell me what better definition of a traitor than someone that tries to warp and corrupt the election process. Rush Limbaugh, I'm coming for you, you little fat bitch motherfucker. I'm coming for you, Rush.